When we started, we had to decide what type of generator to use, and the supplies needed to build it. After doing some research, we finally decided on an AC generator design. We went out and bought the materials, but had to wait on the magnet for our design due to the fact that we had to order it. Once we had all the supplies, we built our design. Our design consisted of a plastic tube made from a 3-liter bottle, which we wrapped the wire around. There was a wooden frame that we attached this tube to, and a metal rod that went through the frame and the tube. This rod is what the magnet attached to so that it could rotate within the tube and create electricity.
We faced many challenges over the course of our project. To name one, we could not drill through the magnet. We had to do this so that we could put our magnet on a steel rod. In order to drill through the magnet, we would have had to have tools that we simply did not have access to. This is obviously a problem. In order to overcome this problem, we taped two magnets together with a piece of plastic separating them. We could drill through the plastic and then use that hole to attach it to the rod. Another issue we ran into was the instability of the plastic tube we used. It was slightly warped, which caused the magnet to hit it. This made the tube flex and move, which made the magnet hit it more. In order to deal with this, we had to make some changes in our original design. We attached a wooden stabilizer to the tube. This reduced the likelihood of the magnet hitting it by forcing the tube into a more cylindrical shape, and it reduced the damage when it did by keeping the tube from moving too much.
After crawling through the dark on how to do our project, we wound up at the McKimmon Center with no idea what to expect from our competition or what to expect from the judges. We took in our project and patiently waited for the project to be judged. When the judges came around, we used a drill to power our generator and produce 0.02 volts of electricity. The judges were impressed with our layout because we not only demonstrated how our turbine worked, but we also had a virtual representation on a laptop as well. Out of hundreds of contestants at Fed, our group placed third, bringing home a nice t-shirt that said winner on the front. Our turbine did not quite work as well as we had wanted it to, because in previous tests we had had results of 0.2 volts of electricity. But overall, the design day was not only a great learning experience by seeing what other groups had brought to the table, but it was also a great experience just by experiencing all the other projects and designs.
If we were to do this project over again, there's plenty of things we would have done differently. For starters, we would have invested in a stronger magnet because the one that we got just wasn't strong enough to produce an adequate amount of voltage. In addition, we would have put more effort into finding a pipe that better suited the length of our magnet. That way, there would be less distance between the magnet and the copper wire surrounding the pipe, and less chance of the magnet accidentally hitting the pipe. Also, knowing the differences between direct current and alternating current at the beginning of the project would have been a great help, because we spent so much time trying to figure out which one would be a better fit for our turbine. And eventually we realized that we actually do not have the materials necessary to build the direct current generator, so we eventually had to go with AC. And knowing this at the start of the project would have saved a lot of time and energy. If we were to give advice for next year's freshmen, the best advice we could give is just to start building early, because you never know what's going to happen once you start actually making your project. Maybe you'll figure out that your project spontaneously combusts, or maybe you'll figure out that the magnet that you paid for online is actually not able to be drilled through. The last piece of advice we'd give to next year's freshmen is just to have a plan for every meeting that you attend. That way your meetings will be more productive and your project will go by a lot easier.